Hoş geldiniz. In today's lesson, we're going to learn the numbers in Turkish. Hemen başlayalım. Evet, first of all, you should really know that you're lucky because the numbers in Turkish are so easy. Because it's so systematic and you might really be surprised how systematic it is. Tamam mı? Let's start with one, which is bir. Bir. Bir. I say bir now, but you might hear it like bir, bir, like bish, something like this, because we somehow make a whistle when we pronounce the re at the end. We do it without knowing. We don't do it on purpose. So, but I just want to warn you because you will probably face this. Okay, but please try not to. I mean, please don't try to pronounce it like us, like with whistle, because as I said, we don't do it on purpose. It just goes, and I really don't know how to describe it. But when I say bir, bir, bir, you might hear it like with something like she, but just try not to do it because people will get you like beş or beş. Beş is five. Tamam mı? Enough useless details for today. Evet, let's go on. Bir, iki, iki, iki, üç, üç, dört, dört. By the way, it's cultural. For one, we do it this way, bir. For two, we do it iki. For three, we don't do like this. We do this, üç. For four, we do dört. I guess everyone does that way in the world, I don't know. For beş, wow, it's so surprisingly we do it like this. Evet. Beş, beş. Bir, bir, bir, beş. I hope it doesn't sound you the same. I know there's a little whistle when we pronounce it, but you can pronounce it like bir, bir, bir. It won't bother anyone and nobody will try to correct you or anything. Tamam? Just feel free to pronounce it like bir or bir. Beş ve altı. Altı. Yedi. Yedi. Sekiz. Sekiz. Dokuz. Dokuz. Ve on. On. Tamam. Let's repeat them. Bir, iki, üç, dört, beş, altı, yedi, sekiz, dokuz, on. Bir, iki, üç, dört, beş, altı, yedi, sekiz, dokuz, on. Tamam mı? Şimdi bakalım. Let's count until 20 now. So we know 10, how is it? 10, evet. Don't worry, we don't have like 11, 12, like when you expect it to be different. Evet, we know bir, 1, 11. 11, 11. We write them separately, okay? Like each word, each number is written separately. So if you see some like native speakers like doing it, writing it like this, just ignore them, because sometimes all native speakers do such mistakes like in every languages. 11. I sometimes write it like this or this way. Some people write it this way, okay? You probably have the same things in your language. 11, 12, 13. See, quite systematic. 14, 15. Guess what? Yes, evet. 16, 17, 18, 19 ve 20. 20. 20 is our 20. 20. 20. Tamam mı? So we know 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So let's see how to say 21, 22, 23. It goes on. There's no exception. Bakalım. Şöyle yazalım. Pardon. 20. Evet. 21. 21. 22. 23. 24. 25. 26. 27. 28. 29 ve 30. 30. 10. 20. 30. 40. 50. 60. I have something to say about this. You see the le here, 60, but maybe 99% of Turkey pronounce this word, this number, like 60. Like we really pronounce it like 60, tamam mı? So you can pronounce it 60 as well, but if you ever have to write it like in letters, you should write this, tamam mı? Otherwise it will be incorrect and it might mean something else, tamam mı? 60, 70, 70, 80, 80, 90 ve 100. 100. 100. Tamam mı? 100 means 100. Let's count now. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. Tamam mı? So if we add the I don't know how to say, like 1 until 10, we can do it this way. 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60. You can say, you can feel free to say 60 instead of 60, tamam mı? I will also say that way, 60. 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70. 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78, 79, 80, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 99, 100. Evet. 100. How would you read this? 100. 100 ve 1, right? But we don't say that way, of course. 101. 101, tamam mı? By the way, 0 is 0. 0, tamam mı? But you will probably will need this for like telephone numbers.
Evet.
Tamam, şimdi buna bakalım. Bu kaç? 101. 101. 101. Tamam mı? And it goes on this way. 101, 102, 103, 104, 105, 106, 107, 108, 109. Bu kaç? 110. 110. Tamam. 111, 112, 113, 114, 115, 116, 117, 118, 119, 120. Tamam mı? It goes on this way. Until... Evet. Bu kaç? 200, like 200. Tamam mı? But when we say 100, we don't say like 100, tamam? We don't say that. We just say 100. 100 means 100. Like we literally we say 100 only, tamam? 200, like 200, but not 100. Just I mean in Turkish, just only 100. 200. You can guess this one. 300, güzel. 400. Şöyle bakalım. 400. Bu kaç? 500. 600. 700. 800. 900 ve bu kaç? 1000. 1000. This is ne, tamam mı? 1000. 1000. Not 1000, not like 1000, tamam mı? Only 1000. 1000. Bu kaç? 1100. 1100. Pardon. Bu kaç? 1110. 1110. Bu kaç? 1111. 1, tamam mı?
This way.
1000. Evet, I'm sure you said it already. 2000. 2000. 3000. Güzel. 3000. 4000. 5000. Pardon. 6000. 7000. 8000. 9000 ve 10000. Sometimes you can also, you know, like to be able to distinguish, you write, you can put this. 10000. 10000. 10000. 20000. See, it goes back in like in many languages. 10000, 20000, 30000, 40000, 50000, 60000, 70000, 80000, 90000. Kaç? 100000. 100000, 200 bin, 300 bin, 400 bin, 500 bin, 600 bin, 700 bin, 800 bin, 900 bin. Bir milyon. This one, from now on, we start to say like bir, like not only milyon, but bir milyon. 2 milyon, 3 milyon, 4 milyon, 5 milyon, 6 milyon, 7 milyon, 8 milyon, 9 milyon, 10 milyon. Evet. 100 milyon, 200 milyon, 300 milyon, 400 milyon, 500 milyon, 600 milyon, 700 milyon, 800 milyon, 900 milyon ve 9 0 1 milyar 1 milyar tamam mı? That's enough I guess. And then after we say trilyon. I guess the camera sees this part. Evet. 1 trilyon. Tamam mı? Yeah, if you are not super rich, you won't need this. Evet. That's basically the numbers. I want to share some other informations about numbers. Evet. Bu kaç? Kaç? Bu kaç? Kaç? When you see this in the questions, it will be your biggest clue that it's about numbers. They ask you some numbers. Mesela, for example, sen kaç yaşındasın? Like, how old are you? Tamam mı? We will do this in another lesson. But whenever you see kaç as a question in the question, you will know they ask you like what number. Tamam mı? It's the thing is, I mean the context is about numbers. Tamam mı? Bu kaç? And this is how we ask like this is how we ask the kids if they actually learn the numbers at school. Like this. Bu kaç? Bu kaç? Altı. Bu kaç? Altı. Bu kaç? Beş. Bu kaç? Dört. Bu kaç? Üç. Bu kaç? İki. Bu kaç? Bir. Tamam mı? That's how we ask. Bu kaç? Bu kaç? Bu. Altı. Altı. Bu kaç? Dokuz. Güzel. Bu kaç? Yedi. Bu kaç? You can pause the video and check your notes if you are taking notes. Tamam mı? Bu kaç? 17. Güzel. Bu kaç? You can pause here. 35. 35. Bu kaç? Evet, 1. 11. Güzel. Take notes and you can make your own combinations. Tamam mı? Did you watch the video how to say where you are from, where you come from? That video. Like, if you watched that, you will remember this rule. Like, if the word ends in a or ı, the suffix, like lı, li, lu, lü, those suffixes, it will take ı form, like which is lı. E, if they end in e, i, they will take e form. O, u will take u form. They end in ö or ü, they will take ü form, like lı, li, lu, lü. It will always be this way, tamam mı? Turkish is all about these rules. So, and this is quite basic one. So, now Let's learn how to say like first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh. Tamam mı? Even one millionth. I don't even know how to pronounce it. Tamam mı? In English. So let's see it. We have bir. Let's write them with numbers. Bir, iki, üç, dört, beş, altı, yedi, sekiz, dokuz ve on. The suffix for that, of course, we will need a suffix as usual in Turkish. It will be like either ncı, nci, ncı, cu, ncı, or with another form like ncı. Like if they end in a vowel, they will directly take this. But if they end in a consonant, they will need this form. You can think that this is actually a helper sound. Ncı, inci, uncu, üncü. Maybe it was probably a helper sound, but with time it became the suffix itself. Like it became eight formed suffix. Bakalım şimdi. So, bir. It ends in e, we can say, because there is only one syllable. We have only one vowel here. So e. Bakalım e, e. Which one will we pick? We know for sure we will pick for e form, right? Which is either nji, nji, or inji. But we will also pay attention how it ends. It ends in consonant, which is re, bir. So it can't be birinci. I have to change the marker. It cannot be birinci, right? It will be too difficult to pronounce, you know us. So it's birinci, this one. Tamam mı? Birinci. Birinci. İki. İki. For sure, we will go for E form, either nci or inci. But it ends in vowel, which is E, so we don't need this one. So we will pick this one. İkinci. Üç. We have Ü. We will go for Ü form. Üçüncü or üçüncü. Üçüncü. Quite straight. No obstacle. So üçüncü. Tamam mı? First, second, third, dört. Dört ends in consonant and it has ö, so it will have to be ü form. So let's do it this way. Dörtüncü. Now, the only one who changes. This t will become d. Tamam mı? It will get softer. So it will be dördüncü. Even if it's 14th, it will be still dördüncü, which is like 14th. I hope you see it on the camera. Let me check. Great. Tamam, 14th or dördüncü. Doesn't matter. Dördüncü. Tamam mı? Dördüncü. Not dörtüncü. Tamam. Let's see it again. It was this way. T. So we know. And it has ö. So we will for sure pick this one. One of those. So we go went for üncü. And we changed this. Dördüncü. Pardon. Evet. Dördüncü. Beş. It has e. So we will go for E form. Bakalım. Beş. Nci. Beş nci. Hard to pronounce. So we will go for easy form. which is 5. I'm relieved. Tamam, 5. 6. Ends in ı, do you see? 6, ı form. Ends in vowel already, so 6. 7. 8. Is it correct? No. 8. Güzel. 9. 9. 10. O, o, u form. So, is it correct? No. 10. Tamam mı? Böyle. Let's see another's. It's quite systematic. I should just add on actually. 10, 11. 11th, I guess pronunciation, I don't know. 11. 12. Why did I clean it? 12. 13. This way, tamam mı? By the way, we don't write it this way. I just want to show in English. 11. 12. 13. 14. 15. 16. 17. 18. 19. Ve how is 20? 20. Tamam mı? 20. So ends in e. 20. Tamam mı? This way. 30. 40. Let's write them. You might ask, why do I really need them? You know, like 20 or something. Maybe you ran a marathon, so you wanted to tell your friends like which place you took, so you might need this. 10. 20. 30. 40. I 40. 50. 60. 70. 80. 90. ve 100. Tamam mı? Like 100. 100. Tamam. Let's see how to say like 1000. It's bin, right? So we will go for this form, the one of these. If you do it, binci, hard to pronounce, so we will pick this one. All of these guys exist for us, tamam mı? Not just to be to make the language more difficult. These sweet guys make the language more easy. I mean, easier for us. Tamam mı? Bininci. And 2000. 10000. 20000. 100000. Like 100,000th. 100000. So let's say you are the 1,000,000th client of the supermarket, so you will get a car. Evet. 1,000,000, right? It's, yeah, after million, and we start to say like not only million but 1,000,000. Evet. Yazalım. 1,000,000. 1,000,000. This is 1,000,000, and like this. And let's see how to. Million ends in o, so it will be u form. Mcu or umcu. Evet. 1,000,000. I'm so sorry for my bad spelling. 1,000,000. My bad writing, I mean. 1,000,000. Tamam mı? Evet. 1,000,000,000. 1,000,000,000. Evet. 1,000,000,000. 1,000,000,000. 1,000,000,000. Tamam mı? So let's see how to write them in letters. Okay, let's see how to write them like numbers and letters like this. First, it was this way, right? In English, I'm terrible. Yeah, second. So let's see how it works in Turkish. Let's write English and Turkish, Türkçe. For the first, we say birinci, right? Evet, birinci. We can also write this way. The number and one dot next to it. Birinci, ikinci, üçüncü, dördüncü. Like in the books, like chapters, for example, or like sections. Like we can write this way. Or the questions, like you want to write like one, like first, second, or one, two. You can read this like birinci, ikinci, üçüncü, dördüncü. For example, in the advertisement you saw, like they give away a car for the 1 millionth client. So they will write like bir milyonuncu, bir milyon, bir milyonuncu müşteri. Müşteri is client or customer. Müşteri, tamam, bir milyonuncu müşteri, this way. And with either with dot or the you focus the way you read the number, which is bir, bir, bir, birinci, with an apostrophe here, tamam mı? Birinci, I'm sure it's so little on the screen. Birinci, ikinci, iki. İki ends in e, iki, iki, we know it. So, iki. So you just put apostrophe and write this part. Tamam mı? İkinci, üç. Üçüncü. Üçüncü also, these are also, these mean the same. Üçüncü. Üç. Üç. Üçüncü, tamam mı? You just write this part this way, and then one apostrophe, and then the rest. Tamam mı? Dört. Dört. We read it as like dördüncü. Dördüncü. Dördüncü. I'm so sorry for my bad usage of the board. Dört. Bakalım. Dört. Let's read it like dört. Dört. Dördüncü. Tamam. Let's give this example. Birinci oldum. Olmak is to be, to become and to happen. Birinci oldum. Like we say like I become the first one, the first, like it means like I took the first place. Mesela yarışmada birinci oldum. Like I took the first place in the race. So birinci oldum. But your family ask you before you say. That's how they ask. Kaçıncı oldun? Kaçıncı? Like which place did you take? So we remember the kaç is related with numbers, and even its question is like related with numbers again, and we directly add this to this, like kaçıncı, tamam mı? And maybe at the classroom your teacher might ask you, let me write it here. Or can ask your teacher this question. Kaçıncı sayfa? Like, what page? Tamam mı? What page? But we ask it this way. Tamam mı? I guess we're done with numbers. I hope we're done because I don't want to edit this. I don't want to shoot another video. So if you found it useful, I mean, if you found it confusing, dislike it, so let me know, so I can change my method. If you found it useful and if you liked it, you know what to do. Çok teşekkür ederim. Görüşmek üzere.